It is the last cup of the spring season. And now we got two elimination series set up. We're going to be sending two of those teams home. And very easily, within the next couple of series, I think we can determine who is going to be able to grab that top four spot. We may know all of the teams from Europe soon. It's going to depend how these next couple of games do go. And to break down all of that, we got Zico, Supetiz, and Venruki. Guys, let's talk about this one, Change My Mind versus ABC. And when we do look at Change My Mind, we already saw them go against Method Black today. It was a little bit hairy, but they already know they're going to land. Do you think ABC is going to be able to start their run?
Hashtag ABC30. DK, DH, Rest the Druid. Copy paste that straight from Method Black's kitchen.
ABC can basically run that composition, but how strong is their...
I love this smiley face.
ABC, only 29% of you think that they're going to be able to take it, but they're going to yoink that composition and say, this is my comp. Let's see if it will be enough. The gates now open.
We've always said about Change My Mind, although they've been kind of one-dimensional with the compositions that they have been running. When they are on this rogue, mage, druid setup, they play it at an extremely high level. We'll have to see if ABC is practicing up to par with what Change My Mind is bringing in this mirror match setup.
I love the start of European rogue mage mirrors as the mages just throw snowballs at each other in the midfield while the rogues try and find each other or the druids. The mages obviously stacking up icicles and trading with each other here in center field. Both druids out of stealth and combat off the mages, so the rogues are really looking for the first assault. If Nyxir Acro gets pulled out, it could spell devastation for the team, but as you were saying in the pregame analysis, Change My Mind have focused exclusively on this rogue mage druid, and they've got a mirror. So let's see if all that time they've put in is going to pay off.
Yeah, Alec looking for a Ring of Frost off the back of a cheap shot coming in from Nyxie. Unfortunately, gets denied. Beautiful denial there by Acro with a cheap shot into a Garrote Silence. Now they're looking for crowd control on Azgrath. Full blind secured on him in Poike. He trades out his trinket to keep Fried Kitty alive. Still not committing the Ironbark just yet. Not enough damage to be found from ABC. Just like Change My Mind. They're going to stabilize, and things have basically evened out completely for both of these teams. Except Fried Kitty, he's already committed his Icy Veins.
Yeah, and that's a threat initiated right now by the team of Change My Mind, and really not banking too much in terms of defense from the opposing team. Alec gets cycling up. I'm curious to see if either team makes a switch over to the enemy rogue or the enemy druid with Vendettas available. Fried Kitty gets kidney shot. Nyxie looking to pressure him. And Poike at the pillar, avoiding crowd control and able to stabilize. Needs to be a bit worried about a potential blink counterspell. They do make a swap onto Nyxie, the rogue, but Azgrath predicted this swap, activated Ironbark before it was even started. Denies an important Glider's Medallion pull from Nyxie because of that play. Druids both low on mana. Azgrath looks to sneak away, I believe, to regenerate mana. I'm curious to see how much he ends up getting off the back of this, because if he is able to regenerate to full, and Poike now trying to do the same, but his mage caught into a smoke bomb. Tranquility to heal through the line of sight effect, but that may not even be enough. Fried Kitty able to blink to safety just in the nick of time, but Azgrath, with that presence of mind, gets a significant mana lead, and there's no defense exchanged on the side of Change My Mind. They're falling behind.
Yep, beautifully done. Cheap shot on him in Poike. Ring of Frost be found by Alec. Unfortunately, gets denied by Fried Kitty's counterspell in the matchup. Polymorph now to Nyxie as they make a swap over onto Azgrath. Is he going to trade out the bar skin? So far, disrespecting, but in the air farm, he might be able to survive. And Poike charges in, gets the follow-up bash. Azgrath finally trading out the bar skin. But way too greedy of plays coming in from ABC. Azgrath really denying that damage, and you can see that Changed My Mind was able to capitalize on that by committing their Gladiator's Maledict trinkets, and then all of a sudden Azgrath, he fell behind way too far behind in order to really stay alive.
What was your prediction, Zico?
Wrong.
Definitely not going to be a 3-0 anymore. Zico, what happened?
Well, they blinded up Azgrath earlier on. Poike also got blinded, of course. And both of these druids running the Moonkin affinity, the balance affinity. And, of course, that's going to remove that frenzied regen from their defensive toolkit. Azgrath uses his Iron Bark onto Nyxie. Not going to have that available for a little bit of time here. And they're going to just pull the trigger here on a big swap. Acrolos still has his Vendetta, so he didn't use it when they actually blinded up Azgrath. He was holding on to that, some of those maledicts as well, and Fried Kitty actually had a flurry proc at the end of that one as well, and there it is, Fried Kitty initiating the burst there with a Flurryproc Frostbolt right there. Nice frozen orb. And they just managed to get a big chunk of damage here. I mean, Poike as well with the follow-up bash. And, of course, the Vanish, Garrote, and Nixie coming in with the peels, but it's not going to be enough. Akra and Fred Kitty there in hot pursuit. And it all comes down to trinketing that blind and then getting punished on it. It's not the easiest thing to really anticipate there, but in general, you want to wait a little bit when you trinket to something gets committed, like a Maledict trinket or, you know, a Vendetta. Some big cooldowns like that get trinket. But that was also two Flurry procs there for Fright Kitty on two Frostbolts. So he had one before the swap actually happened, shot that to initiate the swap, and then he casted one Frostbolt in the swap that gave him another Flurry proc, which is what landed him the kill. Despite that, though, I still think Akros Vanish would have been enough to chase Asgraph down in that situation. So, just a well-played swap there.
Yeah, you know, Venruki, you've been a competitor before, so you may know the answer to this better than me, but I think it's really important if you're ABC. You kind of need to take a step back away from that game, almost get it out of your mind, pretend it's not part of the series. Maybe you head over to the shop, buy some of the new toys that actually support the AWC and the MDI, help beef up that prize pool. Maybe you do that to clear your head. Maybe anybody could do that to clear their head after such a crazy game. I don't know. I've never competed on the biggest stage like you have, Venruki. Maybe that's the right play.
I think refocusing up, potentially playing with some toys, could be an answer for them. But for ABC, in all seriousness, they have not secured their top four yet. This series is really important to them. They can't be throwing away games like this. Now down 1-0, but the thing is, if these guys are going to be playing out a mirror match, they're not in that bad of a situation. We know ABC, they're very powerful competitors. Alec and Nixie, Asgarath, this is the team that won BlizzCon together. So you know they have synergy with that mage druid of Alec and Asgarath. And I think they can go toe-to-toe here with Change My Mind, but it's difficult. The pressure's on, like you said, losing that first game with sort of a blunder. I really feel like there was just a really greedy plays coming in if he had Barskin a little bit earlier on. The swaps are very telegraphed. As soon as that frozen orb lands, you know they're committing quite a bit to it. So that would have been a great opportunity, but hopefully lesson learned for them. Now, like you said, they just need to really concentrate on these next few games, because if they lose the series, they may be throwing away their chance to qualify to that spring finals.
I'm curious why ABC isn't locking in the DK DH Restadruid. They've been practicing it. We saw them bring it out on broadcast once. It didn't look that great when they tried it in a mirror against Method Black, but since then, they actually have been playing it a lot in the offline bracket, and they've been having good success with it. And that's what Method Black has been beating Change My Mind with. I would assume that ABC was going to bring that out, and that's why I made my original prediction. I thought, okay, ABC are going to play DK, DH, Restadruid. Method Black are 15-0 against Change My Mind with this composition. Now, ABC probably not going to be on the same quite like skill level there in terms of that comp, but I still think that they played good enough that potentially they could be getting a win on the board against Change My Mind's Rogue Mage with it. A little bit surprising to see the mirror come out. I mean, personally, I would love to see mirror all the way through, but I'm just a little bit shocked that they didn't bring that out when they know it's so strong against what Change My Mind is running.
Yeah, and Sid, I kind of want to ask you, why do you think that blind pick unfolded the way that it did?
I don't think it should have. Method Black are 15-0 with one composition against Change My Mind. Demon Hunter, Death Knight, Restoration Druid. ABC have that, but maybe they're not confident enough to take out Change My Mind, who has, again, focused on their Rogue Mage. Potentially a more inferior Death Knight Demon Hunter to Method Black is enough for Change My Mind to overcome that disadvantage. So it could be that going through ABC's mind. They're saying, well, we're a Rogue Mage team. We're better odds going into Mirror. But even that doesn't play into the style. We've known ABC in the past, Tempo Storm is Counter Storm. They've always been the team that just pulls other people's comps and tries to counter the other team. So it's really surprising to see them go for the mirror. Maybe it was a bit of a flex on their part to try and outdo Change My Mind. But now going on to this composition makes a lot more sense.
Weird flex, but okay. ABC now going to move into a composition that we've seen get it done even today against Change My Mind. How do you feel about ABC changing it here? Not in the blind pick, but once they do get to Dalaran Sewers.
Well, I think this is a good matchup, and I think they know that. Potentially what ABC was afraid of was the Shadow Priest Mage. So if Change My Mind did bring in Valet on the blind pick, played the Shadow Priest Mage Druid, that's what ABC was going after with that Rogue Mage Druid setup. But Change My Mind, realizing the situation beautifully, they did pick up game number one in the mirror match. Now ABC on the small map of Dalaran Sewers. ABC, they have to know exactly how this matchup's played out. Like we've kind of talked about, they've got to witness Method Black beat Change My Mind 15-0 with this particular composition. So we'll have to see what ABC can get done, because like we kind of talked about, Change My Mind, they have been playing really, really high-level Rogue Mage. And even against Method Black, there's been windows of opportunity for them. And potentially, if ABC doesn't play on that level, they might be able to find some openings.
Yeah. Usually if somebody sneezed on broadcast, I would just let it go, keep moving on. But that was actually the cutest sneeze I think it has ever been on the internet. That was like cat video status. Just very cute sneeze. Super TG, you look really good today. I like the bow tie a lot. Zico, now that we see this matchup in front of us, do you think that, let's say they take this one down, do you think that they can navigate the win throughout the entirety of the series? Because as Ven already mentioned, Shadow Priest is going to be something in the back of their head. They have to think about Valet coming in. Potentially, they play the Rogue Mage against it, but they're not going to have the chance to straight up counter comp unless they can win a swing matchup.
Well, yeah, I think Ben is right about this. Change My Mind's Shadow Priest game, I actually think that they could have potentially maybe taken a map off of Method Black if they hadn't played that matchup on Mugambala. So I feel like ABC, they have some options that they could run. I think this is a matchup that comes down to the blind to some degree, but the swing match is for sure winnable on the losing side here. I think if we see a small map, ABC can safely lock in what they've locked in here and not really care that much about the Shadow Priest Mage. And if we see a large map, ABC, they also have a phenomenal Elder Shaman in Jamie. They have the Frost Mage of Alec. They can go for that Ellie Mage. Probably going to be played against a Rogue Mage, but on a large map, we have seen the Ellie Mage win sometimes. Although unfavored, it's definitely possible. And yeah, I think ABC is definitely still in this, but this could potentially be one of those series that really does go the distance. We're going to have to see the next game is going to be decided here on Dalaran Sewers.
Yeah, I think that this is one, too, where the blind pick is all of a sudden taking extra weight. We didn't expect this to be one that was going to rely very heavily on that blind pick, but the changes in the meta, and when we see Valet basically moving up to a whole nother power level, we're going to see that composition shine even more. We even saw it potentially take games against some of their toughest competition in Method Black. It needs to be in the back of your mind that makes the blind pick more important, and it makes them deviate from that winning strategy that we expected to potentially see, that we do see here now in game number two, which should be ready in any second. And here we are, Change My Mind leading by one. The game already underway.
All right, so interestingly enough, Minpoike is going to be running that Relentless, and I think he's running that to avoid some of the incoming mana rifts for Jamie. So Jamie has to commit a lot more. Can't just be landing the mana rifts off a single Fel Eruption anymore, and I think that is intelligently done by Change My Mind, just making it as difficult as possible for Jamie. We've seen Raikou do an excellent job on that Demon Hunter, making sure he's hunting down Minpoike. He's constantly landing the mana rifts, but if Jamie can't play on that same level, like we kind of talked about, Change My Mind could definitely win this matchup.
All right, it looks like Change My Mind are focusing on that aggressive strategy of going after the Druid, in this case, Azgarath. If Akrolos can stay on target with that Chains of Ice, very difficult for Akro to even get to his target. Azgarath kiting effectively around the boxes. Minpoike crowd controlling Jamie, denying some further mana rifts. However, on Dalaran Sewers, going to be almost impossible for him to ever drink. Azgarath gets caught again in a stun out of bear form. Big mistakes by ABC in game number two.
Yeah, Darkness gets traded out by Jamie to keep Azgarath alive. Still, of course, does have his Gladiator's Medallion and Iron Bark if he needs it. So Jamie just preemptively trading out that 3-minute Darkness. Now, Azgarath, he does, of course, have defensives he can rotate through, and eventually maybe Jamie can get that second Darkness out in a little bit of a later game, but being caught out of bear form consistently into those kidney shots is a dangerous game to be playing for ABC.
All right, just now a swap onto Jamie. Change My Mind trying to mix it up here and catch him off guard. If Change My Mind can manage to win here and put ABC on match point, that's going to be devastating. If ABC lose this series and go in fifth place, there's opportunity for Plot Twist to pass them and take their fourth place finish at the spring finals. ABC cannot afford to lose.
Look at Jamie just caught into an entangling roots. Minpoike has been dancing circles around him in this particular matchup. Finally, a Fel Eruption is going to land into a mana rift. Does he get the follow-up? Yes, Imprisonment secures that mana burn onto Minpoike. He's hovering at around 60% at this particular point in the game, but Nixie really hasn't been able to generate too much pressure. Fried Kitty seems to be completely fine. Now a swap here onto Jamie. Caught into a kidney shot with a full blind onto Azgaroth. What are they going to be able to get done? Can they take Jamie down? And Jamie's just abandoning. Look at him. He's way out of position. They might be able to punish him. Jamie could easily fall. He tries to deny the drink, but potentially overextending, gets a cheap shot. Relentless. Netherwalk, but fortunately, allows Jamie to survive, but that was really risky positioning coming in from ABC.
He was trying to stop Minpoike from drinking, but Minpoike actually was able to, which is unexpected on this map. If Change My Mind were going to pull a victory against this composition, this is looking like the best shot that they've gotten so far, as Minpoike actually has a mana lead over ABC. Jamie with limited defense could be a vulnerability to a smoke bomb. Azgaroth gets cycloned. Nixie Shadow steps over, going after Jamie, holding onto the smoke bomb, waiting to see if the crowd control chain gets dropped. Not enough damage to do too much. They do get a polymorph. Good chain by Change My Mind. Jamie on the run, trying to pull back, but gets bursted. Azgaroth has to make a quick decision as to whether or not to use Iron Bark. He does not want to overlap it with Blur. But now Smoke Bomb gets dropped by Acro as they continue the chain. Jamie ducks out of that quickly. Now caught into another stun. Azgaroth connecting some regrowths. A bit wary of that Shadow Step kick potentially from Acro. Azgaroth now sneaking away, realizing that he is going to need to drink to stay in the fight. Minpoike sees him, tries to deny it. Not able to find him just yet. Azgaroth is in stealth, sneaking away. Acro goes for the Shadow Sight. Crystal is now able to see Azgaroth and should deny it. No mana regeneration for ABC. Minpoike, I do believe, is still in the lead in terms of mana. They've gotten major defensive cooldowns. Change My Mind are looking solid here.
Yeah, they're looking incredible. Like we kind of talked about, when they play this Rogue Mage Druid setup, they play it at the highest level, and ABC is clearly making a little bit of mistakes in this matchup. Another kidney shot secured onto Azgaroth. What are they going to be able to get done? Fried Kitty just teeing off with Frostbolts. Nixie just caught into a Frost Nova out of line of sight, really not being able to back him up at all. And he could easily just fall. He still has the Renewal and the Iron Bark. Doesn't want to be too greedy getting into bear form. Will ultimately be able to survive as Jamie comes back.
He drank!
Undercut pressure, but Minpoike during that moment was able to sneak away for a drink, and now at 100% mana, things are looking so good for Change My Mind.
Big mistakes from ABC here in game number two. This was supposed to be their map and comp advantage, and things are slipping away and out of control quite quickly. Their fourth place spot potentially on the line to qualify to the spring finals is slowly falling apart. Azgaroth desperately trying to stabilize as Acro looks to kill him by himself. Not able to find it. Fried Kitty, Minpoike move to center field. I'm curious if they're going to jump right on top, try and crowd control Jamie. They place the frozen orb. They go for the kill. Azgaroth denies it with Iron Bark and Bear Form. Nice play on his part, denying a huge amount of damage during this push. They decide to commit the anti-magic zone regardless. Fair trade with the Vendetta. ABC exchanging one for one in that regard, but Azgaroth needs to drink, and he needs to drink soon. If Change My Mind can deny him, I'm not sure if they're going to be able to pull it off. Azgaroth sneaks off. Acrolol denies. Minpoike in position as well, right on top of him, looking for a cheat. Cyclone, and then they swap to Jamie, catching him off guard. Potentially a flurry available, huge damage. Ray of Frost fully channeled. Azgaroth out of position, still Cyclone down below. Hibernate attempt, and Poke not able to find, but gets a bash for Fried Kitty to potentially set up a polymorph. They need to stop the reverse magic, not able to find it, but they Cyclone Jamie at low health. And Poke on fire.
And Poke doing an excellent job looking for a follow-up Cyclone, manages to find it on Jamie. And now Acro putting pressure onto Azgaroth, really forcing him to make a difficult decision, but ultimately ABC looking like they might recover. Kidney shot on Jamie. If they have any damage, it could be dangerous. Iron Bark, I think, will deny this kill. Jamie still has the Darkness as well as the Netherwalk he can use to survive, but Change My Mind, they have just been in the driver's seat in this game, and Poike's mana doing great. But now a mana rift secured by Jamie will put him a little bit behind, and that offensive play by Minpoike might end up biting him in this series or in this particular game. He had such a massive mana lead but fell behind a little bit, but you really can't blame him looking for those offensive opportunities. Could potentially even be sneaking away for a drink.
Smoke bomb attempt. Minpoike jumps into the smoke bomb to try and cyclone Azgaroth if he moves forward. He's not able to move forward. Tranquility needs to be enough healing. They cyclone Jamie at low health. Acro moves over. Maybe he's going to kidney shot Azgaroth, set up for Fried Kitty to get a polymorph, something along these lines. Maybe they go for a swap. Change My Mind are trying to change things up here in game number two, catch Azgaroth off guard. Nixie instead, Terminator style at the healer. Jamie gunning down for Fried Kitty, trying to create some split pressure. Nixie now convening over with him, both members connecting. Acro is attacking Azgaroth, catches him out of form. Fried Kitty not in position. Curious to see if he blinks in to try and deal some damage. Not going to be. Instead, polymorphing up the DPS members from Minpoike to try and sneak away. Nixie denies it with that Death and Decay. Azgaroth still getting pressured. And the thing is, if Minpoike can maintain his mana deeper into Dampening, Nixie then becomes a target.
see Azeroth's mana is not doing well, already down to around 15%. I think it's really unlikely he's able to sneak away for a drink. Ray of Frost being channeled out with Icy Veins. Azeroth doing a good job. Line of sight,
caught.
Once again, caught into a kidney shot with a bash onto Jamie. Good cross crowd control coming in from Npoike, but gets denied that Cyclone by Nixie. Excellently done. Good backup, and now Jamie can continue the assault onto Npoike. He can land these mana rests. He will be able to even up the mana of both of these teams. We're at 20% dampening. Things are going to start really getting interesting for both these teams.
Npoike still with a mana lead. Curious to see what they can get done. Azeroth gets in bear form right before the incoming stun. And Acro gets peeled away by an asphyxiate. Azeroth easily survives, and with zero mana remaining, 20% dampening, things are getting dicey for ABC here. Potentially change my mind, can take this, and then basically ABC have to pray that Plot Twist don't get to a third place finisher. Otherwise, they're not going to the spring finals. This is devastating for ABC overall. Are they able to get a drink off the back of that death grip? See, Azeroth not able to, I don't believe, regenerate any mana. Still completely tapped. And Poike's moving in. Nixie is now a target. Dampening ramps up and change my mind. Might be able to pull it off.
Yeah, anti-magic zone trades out with the Ironbark, but Azeroth, he has no mana left. Nixie in a lot of trouble. Acro still trying to take him down. Gladiator safeguard Frostbite. Kitty trying to get out as much damage as possible. Anti-magic zone now fading. Darkness gets traded out as well. ABC trading out their entire defensive arsenal to keep Nixie alive. They have to start trying to find some counter pressure, but change my mind. Everything just going in their favor at this particular
Vendetta
game. Vendetta gets traded out onto Nixie, or in a couple seconds will be traded out onto Nixie, and that's going to be a huge offensive capability push for Change My Mind in this matchup.
He could just die. There's 10 seconds away for Ironbark. Dampening is so high, if Fried Kitty can avoid some death strikes, maybe an aggressive evasion, something. They need to stop the death strikes. Kidney Shot will stop it for now, but Ironbark is available in one. Azeroth likely to press that immediately. Nixie will recover. Dampening not high enough just yet for Nixie to ultimately go down. That was the opportunity to find the kill. They don't net it. Now Change My Mind on the back foot as both teams are totally tapped on mana. Ray of Frost gets interrupted. Smoke Bomb in desperation. Acro tries to set up for the kill but not able to find it. Nixie denies. Two members low. Npoike with nothing, and this game is falling out of control for Change My Mind now. Acro Shadow steps out defensively. Fried Kitty left alone in midfield with a double Frost Nova. Aggressive reverse magic to get the Frost Nova off and reconnect and ultimately claim the kill here against Fried Kitty as Npoike desperately times some heals with Innervate. He's got free healing for a couple of seconds, and Nixie now getting bursted down. Suddenly an opportunity for Change My Mind to stay alive in the fight, but dampening not high enough yet to take Nixie down. Acro gets stunned away, unable to connect. I think the magic number is 40% to kill a Death Knight, and they're just not there. They're so close.
Yeah, definitely so close. Azeroth denies the kill with the Ironbark.
But we will be moving forward into deeper stages of dampening now with no ice blocks remaining. Change My Mind only have a few more moments left to get a kill, but I don't think they're deep enough into the fight to be able to net it. Can they pull off a miracle? They pop the Icy Veins, but he gets gripped on the Frost Bolt. Fried Kitty just can't deal enough damage to take him down. He's getting crushed. ABC look to close and tie this series up with a Solar Wrath from Azeroth. Fried Kitty holds on by a thread just in time for Ironbark. Are they going to pull it off? All three members have changed my mind. It's critically low on health. Nixie stabilized with the anti-magic shield. Jamie in hot pursuit secures a double stun. There's no mana still in the tank from Npoike, and Fried Kitty is going to get sliced. ABC tied the series up, but that was shaky.
Oh, it definitely was. And the question is, did we see a bigger choke there than what we just heard from Venruki inside of the arena? There are so many different points within that matchup where you start looking at what's happening with the DH, you look at that composition, you just say, okay, maybe I realize why they didn't want to play it. It doesn't look like it's as practiced. It doesn't look like it's as high of caliber as we see with some other compositions. But then all of a sudden, there's a big shift in what we see here on Dalaran Sewer, Zico.
Yeah, they finally got Minpoike's mana bar down, and the big problem was that they managed to get a lot of drinks here on the side of Change My Mind, and that really did put ABC behind, but they managed to keep their defense up. They managed to keep Azeroth alive from a lot of those deadly switches that we saw earlier on, and then eventually Minpoike was put in that checkmate situation where he's no longer going to be able to go for drinks, and of course Fried Kitty, he's not going to have much self-healing compared to Nixie and Jamie, and the pressure is going to start mounting up for ABC, and this is really the matchup that I want to see from them. But I think we, like you mentioned already, kind of figured out why they didn't want to play it. It didn't look as clean, of course, as when Method Black played it, and playing it on Dalaran and playing it on Naggron in the opener might have actually been really bad for them, because on Naggron it's even easier to get those drinks off. I mean, Poika, seeing how he actually managed to get like two full drinks off on Dalaran, could have been a quick loss there, actually.
The question is, are we going to see a composition that, let's be honest, doesn't look tournament caliber right now, but has the advantage, or are they going to switch it up when we return after this quick break? Game today if you head over to the store, but we're definitely seeing it in the arena as well. Fireworks all over the place as we start to determine who that last team is going to be from Europe to make the jump, to make it to land. My name is Rich. I'm going to be your host. I'm joined by Zico, Supertees, and Venruki. Let's talk about how the series has looked so far. There was a composition that we wanted to see. You got a squad that's gone up against it, one of the best teams to play this composition, though. Keep that in mind. And they're 15-0 against it. The composition comes out. The team doesn't look as well rehearsed. What do you think we're going to see in game three?
First, okay, we need to see. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I was going to say we need to see which map we're going to. A large map would maybe indicate something like the LA Mage from ABC, but a small map, I think going for the RMD mirror is it's a good play, even if your RMD isn't as well polished as Change My Minds, because you know you play more compositions than they do, so you haven't practiced it as much. Even then, I think it's still a, you know, you can get a nice swap over to a druid or a rogue, you know, and ABC definitely have played a lot of rogue mage, so It's definitely a winnable counter pick or a winnable blind pick, because it's most likely going to be going to the mirror. It's of course a nice answer to the Shadow Priest Mage. Now I changed my mind. They don't want to be playing the Shadow Priest Mage, so they're probably going to lock in the Rogue Mage, and then that makes it, you know, it makes it a 50-50.
All right, let's talk about Valet. Can Valet be broken out in this series for Change My Mind?
Well, I think for Change My Mind, it's likely they will go with that mirror matchup once again. I think that's the matchup they want. They're very confident in it. I think we'll really only see Valet being brought into the series if it comes down to ABC blind locking in one of their cleave setups, or if they decide to go to a larger map, then all of a sudden Change My Mind can comfortably lock in the Shadow Priest Mage and have a chance against that Rogue Mage. So I think those are the only two conditions we really see Change My Mind switch it up and bring in Valet, try out the Shadow Priest Mage, Restoration Druid, because it is a really solid composition for them. They really only have two compositions we've seen them be exceptionally well practiced on, and that is definitely one of them.
So, Supertees, why do we see Hook Point as the selection here for this map?
I'm curious, actually, why Change My Mind wanted to go for Hook Point. What are your...
I think that...
a small map?
Yeah, it's for sure the takeaway, because ABC... they want to lock in the DH DK, but they didn't want to lock it in on Naggron, and that's because Naggron is, you know, one of the bigger maps. And if you take away Hook Point, you've already taken away Dalaran Sewer, or you've already played Dalaran Sewers, then it leaves you with what, Blade's Edge and Black Rook Hold, right? And after that, you have to go to a big map.
Yeah, there aren't going to be as many small maps left in the pool. This is something that we see get even more deadly when you do make it all the way to that final, that grand final on Sunday for both of our regions, when it's a best of seven as well. And strategies like this have become more and more important as we see teams really thinking about when this counter comp game is so in meta, when it is so important to actually be counter comping. The way that you look at maps and the way that you actually block maps is going to be important as well. So they're going to be able to take one of the small ones off the table, one of the best small maps as well, when they know that they're setting up a mirror situation. Definitely heads up play on the side of Change My Mind. As we do get down into this one, though, if Change My Mind is able to take it, how does the rest of the series look for ABC?
Well, I think what is likely to happen if ABC falls here is we go to one of the smaller maps like Black Rook Hold Arena, and I think at that point, Change My Mind, they'll likely have to lock in the Rogue Mage Druid once again, and then ABC can look to use that counter comp with the Demon Hunter Death Knight to try to tie up the series. But having that advantage, Change My Mind, definitely things and the series are going to be in their favor if we do go to a Game 5, and I think it's going to be really difficult for ABC.
I'm actually wondering... On the last map, it feels like they should just lock in a big map anyway.
Yep.
Because if it goes that way, game five will be played on Blade's Edge or Black Rook Hold. So we'll play this map, and then after that, it's still Black Rook Hold and Blade's Edge, and then the series is over. You've played five maps. So I feel like maybe it's not even that smart to try to take away Hook Point right now. Hook Point is actually decent if you're playing into the DH DK, I think, compared to Blade's Edge at least.
Important things to think about when we talk about maps going back and forth. But now, let's just see what Hook Point's going to do for Change My Mind in ABC.
Yeah, we saw the Restoration Druids being the vulnerable target in this matchup, especially if they are going to be playing that balance affinity. I'm curious to see if Minpoike or Azgaroth are going to be switching that up in this particular matchup. As it is such a small map, it's going to be easy for these teams to make swaps onto the enemy healers.
We also saw mana taxed heavily early on. Azgaroth was able to drink and regenerate that, but then ended up throwing the game away with a bit of an underreaction to a swap to him. So I'm curious to see how mana plays out on Hook Point. So difficult to find drinks. Already early aggression towards Nixie, pulling major defensive cooldowns from his lineup. Azgaroth still locked down in crowd control. Nixie could fall very early on here. Evasion at low health. Is he going to be able to hold on? Ray of Frost fully channeled. Fried Kitty moves in. Spell steals off. That's Gladiator safeguard. Nixie still exposed, but Azgaroth finally out of crowd control. Connects the Iron Bark, which should start to stabilize Nixie. However, they've burned basically their entire defensive lineup, and moving forward, Change My Mind are in the driver's seat.
Nixie, no Vanish, Evasion, Cloak of Shadows, Trinket. Azgaroth has no Trinket, no Iron Bark. Change My Mind is potentially just one setup away from closing out this game. We'll have to see what they can get done, but there are a few openings here. And Poike with no Trinket, they might be able to make a swap over onto him. We'll have to see what they decide to get done. Acro now looking like he wants to get some damage rolling onto Alec, but unfortunately unable to find it. Good denial there. Polymorph spam coming in from Alec to really slow down the enemy team. What's going to happen? Both teams completely stabilized at this point in the game.
Alec expecting to be the target, went for a really defensive build with a temporal shield, and he's not even getting attacked. They've been going after Nixie instead, so really no value from Alec on that honor talent selection. Nixie the target, Azgaroth blinded, able to pre-Iron Bark before this effective crowd control was initiated. They do continue the chain. Iron Bark's defense will fade. Nixie needs to run and evade and avoid attacks as long as possible, but they do both connect. Huge damage, no defense. Will they be able to just outright kill him? No, big Swift Men stabilizes the team and ABC stay in it, but Change My Mind continue to build the lead.
That was a blind setup coming in as well from Acro, and ABC was able to effectively deny it. Bash now onto Azgaroth with a kidney shot onto Nixie. What is Nixie gonna do? Using that sprint with maneuverability to escape. All over Minpoike with no Trinket. He chooses to activate the Barskin. He's not messing around whatsoever, but still getting low. Azgaroth extends the chain with the bash. Minpoike could just easily fall. Do they have any more damage? Safeguard procs. He has Trinket. He has Iron Bark. What is Minpoike going to do?
He dispels off that Gladiator's Maledict, which would have absorbed all of his heals. Managing to somewhat stabilize. Still very low on health. Catches a regrowth. Looking for some Cyclones right in their face. Azgaroth falling behind on mana. Nixie now with Gladiator's Medallion is feeling a lot more comfortable, though. Fried Kitty the target for ABC. The early aggression we saw from Change My Mind is all but evaporated now. There's no cooldown lead really in that regard. They still have a mana lead at least, and on Hook Point, unlikely that we see either Druid able to really regenerate any mana. Alec at Cyclone, Nixie the target. Azgaroth in position at that wall, able to duck in and out of line of sight, trying to avoid an incoming counterspell, but not able to do it too much about it. And Poike actually gets counterspelled by Alec. Now into a blind. Great chain initiated by ABC. If there was an opportunity to get an ice block, this would be it, but they're not finding enough damage just yet. Fried Kitty avoiding the attacks, polymorphing up the team and denying a potential ice block force here. Great maneuverability on the side of Fried Kitty to avoid that, but it has now cost Minpoike a huge amount of mana to recover. Nixie gets caught in the smoke bomb. Azgaroth ducks in, connecting an Iron Bark just in the nick of time before getting crowd control. That stabilizes Nixie. That secured them a lead, and ABC are crawling back into this.
Yeah, Azgaroth, he's playing it greedy into the full blind, not tricketing out, into the full sap. What is he going to do? It looks like Nixie should be able to stay alive with the feint. Azgaroth doing it smart. He does not want to give Change My Mind an opportunity to make a swap onto him. That was the major win condition we saw on the Grand Arena from Change My Mind. A big all-in attempt with three Maledict Trinkets. Azgaroth does not want to make that mistake again. I think that was an intelligent decision. Fried Kitty under pressure into the full kidney shot. Counter kidney shot onto Nixie. Acro doing a good job slowing down some of that damage. And now Azgaroth getting interrupted. Nixie's incredibly vulnerable. No Cloak of Shadows for another 5 seconds. Ray of Frost gets polymorphed by Alec in full desperation. With Nixie out of line of sight and defensive cooldowns rotated back up, he will ultimately survive, but that was a very close call for ABC.
Significant strategy difference between these two teams, with ABC going after the Mage and Change My Mind going after the Rogue. This pull needs to get an ice block. They've got crowd control Minpoike, and they've got Vendetta rolling on Fried Kitty. Fried Kitty immediately respecting that situation and trades out ice block before he is very low on health and unable to recover as the crowd control chain is extended. They can't deny it. Cyclone secured. Acro locked out of the fight. Fried Kitty still in a 3-on-1. They're committing the Glyer's Maledix. They're going all in on the Hypothermia to find a kill on the Fried Kitty. How much longer can he stay alive? Cyclone now at low health by Askarath. Mana evening out as we step into dampening. Smoke Bomb gets dropped. Nixie looking to try and close in this one window. Potentially a swap onto Askarath from the team of Change My Mind as they mix things up. Gladiator's Maledict. Askarath dispels. Is there a follow-up Gladiator's Maledict? It doesn't appear to be the case. Askarath stabilized, but Minpoike now caught in a polymorph. Could be an attempt to pull the second ice block so soon from Fried Kitty in succession. This would be devastating for Change My Mind if they can do so.
Yeah, bash on Minpoike, polymorph on Acro. Beautiful crowd control coming in from ABC. Fried Kitty getting lower. Could be the second ice block, but Ironbark looking to deny. Follow-up Cyclone coming in from Askarath, looking to deny the heals. Now Cyclone on Fried Kitty. Beautifully done by ABC, by Askarath, to really slow down Minpoike, not allow him to recover Fried Kitty, but ultimately it looks like he will. Now full kidney shot being secured by Nixie. The damage still rolling. Sap onto Askarath. Nicely done by Acro. What are they going to be able to get done? Nixie vulnerable. Uses evasion, trying to avoid some damage. Shadow Step kick onto Fried Kitty on that Frost. Will allow him to survive. Now a kidney shot with a full blind on him in Poike. Fried Kitty, this could be his second ice block.
I mean, both Nixie and Fried Kitty in a bit of danger here. Ring of Frost Poly, great crowd control by Alec. Fried Kitty locked down. Nixie looking to close this out. They get the clone. They need a bit more damage. Where's the damage? They're just not finding it. Fried Kitty cycloned at low health again by Askarath. Bojur is basically tapped on mana. 10% dampening. Alec has Icy Veins rolling. He swaps some damage over to Minpoike, trying to catch him off guard and burst him down. Huge flurry combo. Minpoike ducking for cover and desperately trying to recover, but I don't think he's going to be able to make it out alive. Barskin at low health. Nixie gunning down for the kill. Dire's Maledict soaks up all of the heals. He gets triple stunlock comboed, and ABC take out the mirror in game number 3.
Yikes. When we look at that one, Change My Mind is able to take everything away from ABC in the opener. It looks like it's going to be a cakewalk. They just take everything away from that rogue. The big question that I do want to ask before we even talk about how the tides are able to change in ABC's favor, I want to ask targeting. It's always a big thing that we do discuss when we're in this Mirror's Eco, and you always do break it down very well, whether or not you want to be going after the rogue or if you want to be going for that more standard mage race.
Well, the Mage Race isn't as dominant anymore as it was in Legion, and a lot of that has to do with lockdown, of course. I think the Rogue is the more threatening target, so more often than not, we usually see the Rogue as the target with those kidney shots, but I think a big reason why ABC were able to target Fried Kitty a lot was because he wasn't running that Temporal Shield, and Alec was, so that did give them a nice edge. But then also, here, I just want to highlight Minpoike, he feels safe. He goes into bear form way too late here because he feels safe. Nixie sitting through that stun, and as soon as Minpoike switches form, Nixie actually trinkets out of that stun and gets the kidney shot. Before that, Minpoike was sitting in bear form, but even there, the barkskin is too late. Minpoike definitely dropped to like 60% before he actually started healing himself. He could have pre-iron barked that easily as well. He just wasn't really respecting it. A little bit greedy on his end, and I think the Druid really is the best target to go for in conjunction with the Rogue. So you want to blind the Druid, you want to combo damage on the Rogue, and then if you can pull the Druid's trinket on the blind, then you can potentially look to get a swap onto the Druid later on with the kidney shot into the bash, and then maybe a Rogue has a Vanish or a Shadow Meld to follow that up with a Garrote or a triple DR kidney cheap shot into a Garrote. And that's what we saw led to kills in both of these mirrors. So that's basically what you have to respect. I mean, Poike dropping to 60% with no trinket before that, and also being a little bit slow on his barkskin there, it's a little bit of a throwaway, honestly.
Yeah, and it's really important to put the targeting under a microscope there, because we see this matchup a lot less now. Typically, you mean, you even look back to last year, you're going to be seeing rogue mages all of the time. And for a long while, it really was. It was all about that mage race. You were looking at blocks and you were trying to figure out who was ahead in that war of attrition. Now we're going to see so many changes to the way that this composition plays, especially in the mirror. It's definitely a whole different ball game. But when we look at this one, do you think that this was a throwaway?
Well, honestly, I have to give Alex some credit. That was an opportunistic swap. What he was looking to do was use his Icy Veins and get aggressive on Fried Kitty, but Azgarath actually cycloned him at low health, so Alex really didn't have much of an option. He basically was going to waste that Icy Vein, so instead he opted to try to find some damage on him in Poike and ended up landing a Frostbolt and an Ebon Bolt, and that's where we saw him get to 60% health. So I think it was just a good read of the situation by Alec, really capitalizing on the fact that he couldn't get damage rolling with his Icy Veins on a Fried Kitty, and they found an opening, which is exactly what they needed. And that was such an important match for ABC, as that was a swing match. All of a sudden, if we go to a game five, game number five will be in their favor. And yeah, things are looking good. Now I really wonder what Change My Mind is going to do.
That's what you drew. It's a swing.
Yeah.
It's Min Poike on a swing. I was so confused as to what that was. And Ben drew like this terrible picture. And he was like,
it's not terrible. Come on.
Yeah, it is. We're not going to look at that right now. But when we do talk about ABC, we also need to talk about the stakes. Because it Change My Mind, they know that they're going to land. Is this important for the entirety of the year? 100%. It definitely is. But when we think about the immediate future, ABC has just a little bit more in this race, Super Tease.
Yeah, if they lose here, that means they go in fifth. If Plot Twist can then manage to secure third, it will then be a tiebreaker between Plot Twist and ABC later on. But Plot Twist might be able to just even get further than third place, which then means ABC doesn't go at all to the spring finals. So fortunately for them, they did win the swing match. And what I love between these two teams is that they are able to predict potential kill windows in the future. So usually you see a Restoration Druid use their Glider's Medallion for blind, and Poike made that trade. Azgarath didn't. And while he was sitting through it, I'm thinking, this is really greedy not to trinket this, because you normally do as the druid. But then that removed the option of switching to Azgarath, whereas then Min Poike was the option to switch to, and they were able to capitalize on it just right there off the end of the game. So it was really good, quick adaptations from both sides, and they're so unpredictable that it's almost impossible to call who is going to take the mirror until just the last couple of seconds.
Yeah, I think one of the things is, too, is once you do start to have that advantage going your way, when you're ABC and you're on match point, it starts to look really good for you, especially when it is somewhat of a volatile matchup, if they do manage to have this as a mirror all the way through. But Zico, I do want to mention what Sid was talking about that trinket usage really quickly here. How often does it go the other way, in your opinion?
Well, the thing is, you can also be punished really hard if you don't trinket. There's definitely a plus side and a downside to it. It all depends on how well executed the swap is as well. Usually, if you have a kidney shot and the orb and the blind comes out all at the same time, it creates so much pressure immediately that most druids are just going to trinket, because otherwise you might having to use all your rogue's cooldowns, and then you have to use the druid's trinket as well on the sap later on, and then all of a sudden, if they land a Bash Ring of Frost, the rogue is dead. So there's a lot of things that you have to consider. Of course, every trinket situation is also different, and that's what these druids have to read into. But I feel like, for the most part, when these druids die, it's at the back of a mistake. I think in the last game, it was a combination of a mistake, but also a nice outplay. Nyxie got kidney shot. Nyxie sat in the kidney shot for like a second. Min Poike was in bear form when he was in the kidney shot. He's like, oh, well, the rogue is stunned, so I'm going to go out and I'm going to heal myself. And as soon as he did that, Nyxie trinketed that stun late and then ran up to Min Poike and just kidney shot, you know?
Ow.
That looked like it hurted.
No, I slowed down before impact.
I think it's important, though.
Unlike Nyxie.
It's important to note, it was one of those moments where not only do you see an oopsie come in on the side of Change My Mind, but a 200 IQ play come in on the side of ABC, right? And when those two things collide, oopsie and 200 IQ, you win if you're ABC, right? If you're on we can see that happen, though, would Change My Mind. I think both of these teams have already proven that in these Rogue Mage matchups, they're both very, very fluent in the script and what they want to be doing. We're seeing these little tweaks, these little nuances come in at particular high-pressure situations. It's all about finding those important swap opportunities, finding those tiny little openings, and these are the two teams to do it. I think if you're a fan of this playstyle, this is the matchup that you have been waiting for. You don't get to see it as much in this meta, but we got a very simple question right now. Mirror, mirror on the wall, which rogue mage will take Ashmain's Fall as the gates now open?
Nice one.
Yeah, that definitely wasn't bad. Gates opening now. What are they going to do? Like we kind of said, the druids are the most vulnerable target in this particular matchup, so look for Min Poike and Azgarath to really pick their moments to use their Gladiator's Medallion. Without them, they're going to be super vulnerable to swaps, especially those all-in swaps. Three Gladiator's Maledix is just such a force to be reckoned with. We'll have to see what they can get done.
Early attack by Nixie to take out Fried Kitty, and this is a matchup that can end at any moment in the game. You do not want to leave your seat at any time between these two teams head-to-head. That fourth-place spot for the Spring Finals land in contention if ABC can go down in the series, but they're on match points. They're looking solid in the previous mirror, but like I said, you do not want to go anywhere. Nixie the target once again for Change My Mind. ABC not looking like they want to go after Acro, but having gotten through Minpoike's Gladiator Medallion, Minpoike needs to get ready for a swap.
Yep, Minpoike getting interrupted, but really no damage to be found on a Fried Kitty or Acro just yet. Nixie looking to reconnect to his target, lands a full kidney shot. Fried Kitty with no trinket, vulnerable. Minpoike backs him up with the Iron Bark, but incredible damage coming in from ABC. A lot of pressure and momentum early on from ABC. You can see Askarov, he still has his trinket available, that Gladiator's Medallion. That means he's not going to be an easy target to swap to. Whereas Minpoike, he's really struggling to keep Fried Kitty alive. And without that Gladiator's Medallion, ABC could turn the pressure on him at any moment.
Fried Kitty still very low on health. It could be an ice block early on. Nixie's still being counter-pressured as well. Blind on Asgrass, so this is where he has to make the decision. Does he use the Gladiator's Medallion?
Oh!
It's Fried Kitty that is low on health. This is devastating for the team of Change My Mind. This was their blind attempt. They're trying to go all in on Nixie, but they have the Shadow Step kidney shot to get through the evasion and behind Nixie. They managed to sneak it in. Nixie then uses the Gladiator's Medallion, opening himself up to Smoke Bomb later on. Nice catch by Acro.
Ooh. Beautiful Cyclone by Minpoike. Nixie trinkets out into a full Cyclone on that before the kidney shot really lands on a Fried Kitty. Now finally, Nixie out of the Cyclone is able to land that stun. Try to get some damage rolling. Going to be able to do. Or is Alex looking for Polymorph right now? Finds one onto Acro. Minpoike still with no trinket. Actually, Alex sneaks in a Polymorph onto Minpoike. This is devastating. Fried Kitty could be forced into his second ice block. Now, a Shadow Step kick coming in from Acro. Cyclone once again going to be denying a lot of that incoming damage from Asgaroth. ABC in complete control at this point of the game.
Yeah, interesting to see how the targeting plays out. However, that Smoke Bomb coming up in 57 seconds for Acro. That's what he's looking to make a play with. Change My Mind to survive another 50 seconds, though, and there's a ton of damage being tossed towards Fried Kitty. Iron Bark almost not enough, and Poike taxed heavily on mana to recover. Nixie now caught into another stun. Asgaroth cross crowd controlled. All three members locked out of the match.
Nice.
Polymorph secured. Great chain. Nixie makes the trade, then moves in aggressively, gets the Gladiator's Medallion from Minpoike, realizes that Minpoike wanted to get a Cyclone, expecting that, and actually stuns him on the trinket, denying the Cyclone even further. Asgaroth may be looking to rotate one of his own. Instead, Cycloning up Fried Kitty to get in position to then try and Cyclone Minpoike. Both druids trying to go at each other with Cyclones, but the mage's pressure is too much. Minpoike pinned at the pillar. Nixie gets bursted. Smoke Bomb up at 14,
Ooh.
Cycloned at low health. This next kidney shot from Acro could win the game.
Yep, the denial of that bonus healing of the Iron Bark. Beautifully done by Minpoike. Acro gets the re-stealth. Garrote onto Nixie. As well, all onto Alec. What are they going to be able to do? Nixie Shadow Steps away. Actually looking for a setup here on a Minpoike who has no Gladiator's Medallion. Minpoike not messing around. Instantly using his Bark Skin, but it's still danger time. Counter kidney shot now onto Nixie. Beautiful peels coming from Acro. Minpoike still not out of it just yet. Looking for an offensive bash onto Asgaroth into a full Ring of Frost. Nicely done, but Minpoike still low. Nixie all over him. Can they close it out? ABC so close to taking down Minpoike and advancing in this tournament, but Minpoike holds on by a thread.
Yeah, but he cost a lot of mana there. He wasn't able to innervate before Overgrowth, and Overgrowth is very expensive heal. He really had to do it, though. Tough decision, but now he's behind him. Actually, still even, surprisingly. They try and switch their attention to Acro, but they've already committed so much offense to Fried Kitty. The swap to Acro might be too little too late for ABC. We could easily be going to a game five between these teams. That fourth place finish to the Spring Finals in contention still. ABC still without a clear route to victory here on match point. They drop the Smoke Bomb. They go for the second ice block push onto Fried Kitty. They really need to get it, but they don't have enough damage to do it. And Poike gets Iron Bark tossed out. Nixie gets stunned away. They manage to sneak in a Polymorph, but I do believe that Iron Bark is going to be more than enough defense unless they can continue the chain. Asgrass in position to continue it. Gets the Cyclone. Great crowd control initiated by ABC off the back of a mistake on Minpoike's part. But ultimately, Fried Kitty able to avoid death for now. Still no defense, no mana left in the tank for Minpoike either. And this is the second ice block. Huge lead for ABC.
Definitely Fried Kitty. No cold snap available for another minute and 45 seconds. One sets up, he can have access to that third ice block, but I don't know if they have enough time. Dampening
again.
And Poike gets polymorphed once again by Alec. Beautiful control from the Frost Mage of Alec, and Fried Kitty once again, he's left all alone. How is he going to survive? Acro in desperation, trades out his Vanish, stunning up the entire team of ABC. Polymorph fan coming in from Fried Kitty, but now into a full kidney shot. That gets denied from Poike, trading out his Iron Bar, caught into a full blind. He has to trade out his Trinket, and now, change my mind, they are so vulnerable. If Alec can land one more Polymorph on him in Poike, there is no defense left for change my mind.
Gotta say, this is quite a treat to see Azgaroth team up again with Alec and Nixie. Obviously, they have been playing together for some time. BlizzCon champions, the three of them, now back in the fight, really showing off here against Change My Mind. They're on match point. Nixie, though, gets caught. Bursted down. Vendetta available on both sides. Huge vulnerability. Minpoike could get all in. They bash him. They go for Fried Kitty instead. Both targets are perfect options. Vendetta gets pulled on both sides. Both teams in trouble. It's match point for ABC. The pressure is on for Change My Mind as Fried Kitty flounders. Minpoike struggling to heal. Limited defense available. No mana left in the tank. Fried Kitty holding on by a thread. Minpoike holding on to Iron Bark as long as he can. Now Cycloned at low health. Nixie gets bursted. Evasion at low health on his part. Both teams at the edge of their seat at this point. This could even be a cross-kill situation.
Fried Kitty, 20 seconds left on that Colt snap for the third ice block. And Poike completely out of mana. Azeroth got into the full blind. He's almost out of mana as well. You can see good pressure here on Fried Kitty into the kidney shot. And Poike sneaks away for a drink. If he can recover mana, this is dangerous, though. If he lets Fried Kitty get too low, he could fall behind. Fried Kitty with his Icy Veins, now looking to get hyper-aggressive here on Nixie. Smoke Bomb gets dropped out. Ebon Bolt gets casted out by Fried Kitty. Nixie getting low. Azeroth there to back him up. Lands the Iron Bark, and I think Nixie will survive off the back of that cooldown.
That drink from Npoike bought his team a bit of a lead, potentially an opportunity to swing this to game five. Fried Kitty gets stunned on the Icy Veins. Nixie has a tough decision. Does he stay on target or retreat away? Looks like they're just going to stay on target and try and race down for a kill. Acro Cloak of Shadows aggressively to try and just end this. Going after Nixie, huge Comet Storm connects from Fried Kitty. Nixie in trouble, limited defense, dampening, ramping up. That Glider's Safeguard protects him. Nixie then looks to reverse it. Npoike 2 seconds away from a Glider's Medallion, but he's walking right into a blind. He has to trinket this. He trinkets the Cyclone. Blind is now a win condition for ABC. Should they be able to make it to that point, but with no mana left, I'm not sure if they can. Nixie low on health. Npoike tries to go for a clone, gets counterspelled. Star Surge instead. Npoike tossing in a bit of damage for his team, trying to push them over the edge. Azgaroth is totally tapped on mana. Momentum in favor of Change My Mind, but Npoike gets caught again. They break it. That's a big mistake on both sides there. Npoike, though, lucky for him, gets out of the crowd control and gives them a huge opportunity to net a kill.
There's the full blind play on Npoike.
Pre-evasion.
Do they have any damage? Doesn't look like it. Acro is going to be able to keep himself alive. And Nixie actually gets the full blind on Npoike, but forced to run away. Ring of Frost gets used as well. All the crowd control from ABC completely wasted. Not able to get anything done. Unfortunately for them, now Acro landing a full kidney shot onto Nixie. Do they have the damage? Fried Kitty, big burst damage coming in. There's a Comet Storm. Everything gets traded out. Cheap shot Nixie with the Cloak of Shadows. Will be able to survive. Still has the evasion as well as the Vendetta. Who is the opening? Fried Kitty, he still has his trinket. They make an all-in swap on him and Poike with a kidney shot. Nixie in a lot of trouble as well. Full blind on Azeroth.
What?
And they take Nixie down. Change my mind. Looking to tie up the series. In the meantime, Poike getting low. But Nixie falls first. Poike should be able to survive. And Change My Mind stays in this series.
Man, in patch 8.1.5, if you're exalted with the Zandalari rep, you can unlock a Zandalari, you can play Druid, and you can unlock brand new transformations into dinosaurs. In this patch, it looked like Poike unlocked a form we didn't even know existed for Druids, and that was Sheep form, but still manages to find the win after getting so much of that backwards momentum. How are they able to turn it around?
It's mostly at the back of that drink, for sure. Obviously, a lot of mistakes there on the side of Poike. Getting sheeped a little bit too much for my taste, but still, he manages to sneak away at a really nice moment to drink. Really good synergy there between him and Fried Kitty. And this is also what we were talking about a little bit in the pregame. This is why you don't really want to go for the mage. The ice block, once you rotate back to that third ice block, you've basically reset everything you've done before that moment in the game. And of course, ABC constantly looking for nice win conditions here. They almost find it on Npoike, but not going to be enough. He still has a bit of mana to work with, unlike Azgaroth. And of course, Nixie is going to go down.
I'm just so surprised that it actually did get turned around there. It seemed like all the momentum was against them, but we got a real series on our hands, folks. We're going to figure out who takes this one right after this. Well, we all know that there's nothing that I love more than a mirror. That's just my brand, and we're going to have to see what Change My Mind and AVC, what their brands are in this game number five that's going to decide. And guys, this can really set up what we're going to see at LAN. It's going to give AVC that chance to actually fight for potentially a tiebreaker, depending on what we see later today, but we might know all four teams that will be going to LAN. Who do you think takes this fifth one, Zico?
I think AVC is looking like they are on the rise here. Small map. Maybe DH, DK, potentially going to be unlocked here for game number five. I want to see the mirror. I just want to see them say, you know what, let's go.
Yeah, I think the mirror is just what we need to see here.
I mean,
probably not.
I mean, to watch, it's probably more fun to see the mirror, but I think if ABC is smart, they're going to lock in the counter comp. I mean, Change My Mind has yet to beat this composition. So as long as ABC doesn't completely choke here on the finish line, I think winning that swing match, setting up this game five, is so beneficial for them. We just have to make sure that they're not overlapping their defensive cooldowns, and this composition seems to be almost bulletproof against Rogue Mage Druid.
I think that that's true, and how important do you think mastering this composition is going to be for ABC if they can make it to Lancet?
I mean, assuming that the meta doesn't change, it's going to be pivotal to their team's success later on this year. And they looked shaky in this matchup, which we've seen Method Black 15-0 Change My Mind. So they've got a lot of ways to go with this composition, but they've got a bit of time as well to prepare. Although their spot is still not locked in, and if they are shaky here in Game 5, their fates may be out of their own hands.
That's exactly what can happen, right? You find yourself in a situation where all of a sudden you aren't deciding whether or not you go to LAN. Your performance isn't going to decide it. You have to rely on other teams. Now, for anyone who hasn't seen this matchup, how does it actually play out for ABC?
Jamie is going to be flying around like Batman. I mean, Poike is going to be the villain that Batman is chasing. And Mana Rift is going to be the utility belt that he uses to win the fight.
Okay. Yeah, that's definitely one way that I could actually hear the cameraman laughing there. I was like, who was that? Oh, man. But when we do look at this one and how we are going to see it play out, I think it's important to keep in mind what Sid said as well. They are not perfect with this composition yet, even though it has appeared to be somewhat bulletproof. When it goes against Change My Mind, Rogue, and Mage, you still have to make sure that you're checking off a few of the boxes towards that win condition.
Yeah, but the thing is, with this composition, they really don't have to be perfect. I just feel like it's such a matchup that's in their favor. As long as they don't completely choke, I think this is a winning situation for ABC. Change My Mind, they're going to have to continue to find openings, get a little bit lucky with their burst damage. When they do find those openings, that's really going to be what they need to take down ABC. And I don't know. I think ABC's in the driver's seat, and this is a great spot for them to be in. Like we kind of talked about, they need to be winning every single series they can if they want to have their destiny in their own hands, which is the situation you want to find yourself in when trying to qualify for a LAN tournament like the Spring Finals.
Once again, though, getting to game number five and getting these things in your favor was crucial. You talk about different things like swing matchups, and we talk about the blind pick and how important that is. ABC wanted to be right here. Would they want to take it earlier? Sure, but if you can make it to game five and actually get to pick this composition when it is fully advantaged, you don't have to play a composition that you're weaker on in a bad scenario, right? Like, they never had to put Jamie and Nixie on the chopping block on this composition when it isn't a favored matchup. That's a beautiful series for AVC, and in the end, that might enable them to get all the way to LAN. Think about how important this game actually is going to be for the entire year. Let's say ABC manages to get to LAN and they win the entire thing. You have to be thinking about a game like this because it's going to be those alts that propel them to that situation that could potentially get them all the way to the finals for the year. Keep that in mind. As we touch down, get this one started. Who is going to take it? Change My Mind or ABC in the first elimination series of the day in the final cup leading up to the first LAN of the year.
Can Change My Mind pull off the upset against a composition that now overall they are higher than 15-0 in just overall against multiple teams? Can they do it? All they have to do is win one time, and then ABC might not be going to the Spring Finals. Everything rests on them. They've got the perfect composition, everything set up in their favor. They just need to execute.
Definitely, we'll have to see what they can get done. Change my mind. They have to find windows of opportunity in this matchup. And Poike taking decent amounts of pressure early on. A big swap over onto Azgaroth. Anti-magic zone already being traded out. That's a Vendetta, so that is a very efficient trade. We really want to see Nixie. Anytime Vendetta gets used by Acro, trade out the anti-magic zone and trade the one for one. They perfectly line up, and that should be enough to keep Azgaroth alive through that attempt.
The next trade we expect to see is Icy Veins and Darkness from Jamie. Azgaroth gets stunned up. Ray of Frost channeled and uninterrupted. That's a fully channeled Ray of Frost, and Azgaroth manages to at least make it out of that alive, because he was able to get into bear form before that incoming burst. If Azgaroth makes even a mistake, Change My Mind will look to capitalize and just close this out. But so far, Azgaroth's looking solid.
Definitely, what are they going to be able to get done? Full blind now onto Azgaroth. Once again, he's opting to sit through this attempt onto Jamie. They have to commit damage in order to force Azgaroth to trade out his trinket. Vanish Sap. Acro still looking to extend the crowd control chain, but Azgaroth, he realizes they are not putting enough damage out onto Jamie. It's a bait to get his trinket, and he does not fall for that bait. Now going to be sitting very comfortable with Renewal, Barskin, Ironbark, Gladiator's Medallion. Things are looking pretty good for ABC early on.
All right. If Jamie is Batman, I think Minpoike we can say is Superman. I think Jamie's a little bit more like Lex Luthor with the Mana Rift, countering the mana bar of Minpoike throughout this entire tournament season. Can Minpoike overcome that disadvantage here? One last opportunity to do it. They've managed to maintain their mana at least on par with Azgaroth so far.
You actually kind of look like Lex Luthor.
I don't know if that's a compliment.
He's cool, dude.
He's just evil.
And bald.
Trying to take over the world, I think.
All right, triple chaos. I'm going to be landing on all three members of Change My Mind. Minpoike getting low with no bark skin, no iron bark. He's vulnerable. Trades out the bark. He's going to stay alive now. An attempt onto Azgaroth once again. Kitty shot, frozen orb, everything being traded out by Change My Mind. But Azgaroth's still healthy, just using that center column in the middle of the map, that pillar, just to avoid a lot of the incoming damage Fraud Kitty has available. As long as Nixie can keep snares up, Azgaroth should be able to kite, but Nixie just abandons him and goes after Minpoike. Wants to try to deny those drinks, and that's going to be really important for ABC. If Jamie can't connect onto Minpoike, then it has to be either Nixie or Azgaroth who is denying him getting out of combat and regenerating that precious mana.
Another mana rift attempt here onto Minpoike. Mana lead established for Azgaroth. ABC are looking solid here on match points. Really, Azgaroth has not made a single mistake in this match in particular, and if their team makes no mistakes on top of this counter strategy, I'm not sure if Change My Mind can overcome that hurdle, and ABC are looking good overall in the spring season. Jamie ducks for cover, jumping out of that frozen orb, trying to go in and now attack Fried Kitty with that I-beam. And Poike gets gripped into a triple stun. All three members use their Gladiator's Medallion on that attempt. Huge overlap from Change My Mind and a huge opening now for ABC moving forward.
Yeah, they didn't want to be caught into that stun, that's for sure. Sap onto Azgaroth, into a follow-up polymorph. Jamie getting a little bit low. Gets over, gets a reverse magic, allowing Azgaroth a little bit of time to connect some heals. Jamie's just going to be line of sighting, trying to avoid damage from Fried Kitty, allowing Azgaroth to actually top him off, and he does manage to do so. Bash onto Azgaroth, but he's going to be completely fine. Fried Kitty unable to find another polymorph. It's not going to be that big of a deal as it was on Diminishing Return. Another attempt here onto Jamie with a kidney shot. Azgaroth responds with a bash onto Acro to slow down some of that damage. Minpoike in a good position here to potentially sneak away for a drink, but Jamie and Nixie, they're doing a great job focusing up, and honestly, this game is looking way better from ABC. There hasn't been many defensive cooldown overlaps. Their pressure on Minpoike has been really solid, and this is setting them up for a win.
Yeah, mana still, I think it's actually even, which is surprising, but Minpoike needs a lead if he wants to win this game into dampening. That 40% mark, the magic number to kill a Death Knight. If Minpoike can make it to 40% dampening with mana in the tank, they could pull off victory through that. Otherwise, they're just relying on ABC, making a mistake. They're trying to go after the weakest link, being Azgaroth on that druid, trying to catch him out of form and burst him down. Now mixing it up, going after Jamie, maybe even trying to delay the mana rift. Attempts for Minpoike to drink. He's sitting down in the room. Jamie's trying to get in there. Should be able to deny the drink and does so. Another mana rift likely to connect onto Minpoike soon. We see Azgaroth still being pressured, but once again in bear form for the stun. Change My Mind, unfortunately, want to be attacking Azgaroth, but if they continue to only attack him, it becomes predictable, and he will just always be in bear form, ready and waiting for that attack. And once again, fair trade from Nixie onto the Vendetta of Acro, who has basically been rotating Vendetta as soon as it's available to try and tax Asgrass mana as frequently as possible. And Poike gets gripped in to another Mana Rift attempt. Now trying to escape back into the starting area. Asgrass sitting through a blind sap. That could be an opening for Change My Mind to go after Jamie. Asgrass is trying to play it slow as he is expected to be the target, but no opening found just yet. Are they going to... There's not enough damage. Jamie will recover. Instead, now Bash from Npoike to stun up Asgrass for the team of Change My Mind to try and go after 2 points of pressure. Mana is surprisingly still even, but you can't be even to win this matchup against AVC.
Yeah, you definitely have to be ahead. Jamie and Nixie are going to be able to keep themselves alive. Asgrass in bear form is going to get huge value from that Frenzied Regeneration. 6% dampening, like we kind of talked about, you need around 30% dampening when you can start mixing it up and going after Nixie in this matchup and start pressuring him down. Jamie looking to deny the drink from Npoike once again. Did he recover any mana? Doesn't look like he was able to, but Npoike constantly running away. And this does more than just try to recover his mana. He's also baiting Nixie and Jamie. He's distracting them, not allowing them to get out max pressure on the Fried Kitty and Acro. That allows Acro and Fried Kitty to start building up some momentum for their team. So as long as Npoike can comfortably continue to kite away, create a lot of space, that's going to deny a lot of the offensive pressure ABC has available.
Jamie dipping fairly low, has his entire defensive arsenal available, would be a bit of a throwaway. Npoike is trying to get a lead on mana for a deeper dampening kill into Nixie, but so difficult with the unholy Death Knight pet chasing him and keeping him in combat on top of a Demon Hunter hunting after him as well. Npoike doing everything in his power to drag this on as long as he can for his team to maybe pull off a miracle and take out a kill, but they're still so far away from that magic number. Unless Asgrath makes a mistake, which getting stunned out of form here is definitely one. First it down to half. That's going to cost him quite a bit of mana to trade through. Any magic zone darkness overlap during Vendetta. Icy Veins available in 3 seconds for Fried Kitty. There's an opening for Change My Mind.
There's a huge opening for Change My Mind. Asgrath, he has his Gladiator's Medallion as well as the Bark Skin. Those are the two defensive cooldowns he's really going to need just to keep himself alive. Nixie's still keeping up the Chains of Ice on a Fried Kitty. Asgrath looking to deny a lot of that incoming damage. What is Fried Kitty going to do? Uses the Icy Veins, but unable to find any damage. Looking for a Frostwolf. Gets interrupted by Nixie. Good denial. Asgrath still trying to use the center pillar to line of sight. Jamie now interrupts Fried Kitty. He's getting completely denied on this Icy Veins. Was completely wasted for Change My Mind. That window of opportunity was lost.
Halfway there to that magic number. Npoike still somehow keeping some mana in the tank. Doing whatever he can. Frozen Orb available. Fried Kitty wants to go for a kill with that. They can maybe pull a Glider's Medallion from Asgrath and blind and make a swap later on. This is really the only win condition I see right now. Frozen Orb. Ironbark's defense has faded. They need a bit more damage, but Acro gets peeled away in a stun. Maybe they just take him out. Huge pressure. Oh. They go all in for the kill in Asgrath. Change My Mind. Have managed to do it. And here today, we can confirm that Superman is greater than Batman.
Yeah, we can also just look at the fact that it's getting tougher for ABC to make it to land as well. Zico?
Yeah, I mean, now their fate isn't really in their hands anymore. It's
Gotham's twist. Unprotected.
I feel like we're...
Am I going too deep into the puns?
Yeah.
I tried.
Isn't
okay?
it
I don't do it very
is
often.
Stronger? No, isn't Superman stronger than Lex Luthor?
Well, that was
Lex Luthor is literally
earlier,
a bald dude. That's it. There's nothing else. There's nothing else to Lex Luthor. There's way more to this series than Lex Luthor. So let's unpack that, and we'll let Lex Luthor simmer the heck down, okay? Zika, what happened in this final game? Why are we able to see it? Why are we finding ABC in such a tough position now?
I really think the map is a big factor, of course, because you can sit in the room and actually get drinks, and it's really hard to deny those drinks compared to a map like Blade's Edge, which also still was available. And also, I think that Change My Mind, they do play the Rogue Mage so well, and that's what it comes down to. You have to be on your A game playing this composition. It looks like ABC really wasn't able to do it, and things like the Darkness and the Anti-Magic Zone being overlapped earlier, that's small or kind of big errors like that really does put them on the back foot. Like here, if you had either of those cooldowns, you could potentially save Asgrath. Npoike almost at that point where he's going to be out of mana, you can start really getting those ice blocks out. But that's going to be it for ABC. Now, plot twist, going to be going up against Surprise Effect. If they can be Change My Mind, That's a tiebreaker.